वसतो मा सद्गमय, तमसो मा ज्योतिर्गमय, मृत्यो मा अमृतं गमय.
राइट, लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द टॉपिक मेंसुरेशन. राइट, सो दिस मेंसुरेशन इज ऑल अबाउट फिगर्स. ओके, यस, सी दिस. So this is class 10 paper 2 topic. Okay, chapter 10 it is. Topic name is menstruation. Okay, right. Right. So yes, menstruation is all about geometrical figures. Okay. So geometrical figures are two types: plane figures or and solid figures. So plane figures we call 2D figures also. So 2D is nothing but two dimensions. Dimensions, okay, right. So solid figures nothing but 3D figures. 3D figures nothing but three dimensions, isn't it? Right. So dimensions. How many dimensions a plane figure have? Two. What are they? Length and breadth. Okay. And 3D figures can have three dimensions: length, breadth and height. Height is nothing but sometimes we see it has a depth also. Okay, right. So plane figures have length and breadth only. We have discussed about that, and they are two dimensional figures. Okay, so look at here. These are the two-dimensional figures we have discussed in the previous classes: circle, oval and triangle, square, trapezium, diamond, rhombus, parallelogram and rectangle, pentagon, hexagon, heptagon, octagon, nonagon, decagon. So all these figures are mathematical figures, okay, which we have studied in the previous class about this. Okay, these are all 2D figures. Okay, all these figures occupies some place. Okay, so these are closed figures, as well as these figures occupies some place. Okay, place, I'm saying place. Okay, right. So next, solid figures. The solid figures has length, breadth and height. So sometimes some objects may have depth also. Okay, there we consider height as depth. Okay, so height and breadth, length are the three dimensions a solid figure can have, isn't it? Right. So these are the solid figures which we use in the mathematics, and we have seen these figures about these figures in the. Okay, so look at there, octahedron. And here it is pyramid and prism, hemisphere and cube, cuboid, cone, tetrahedron, cylinder and sphere, dodecahedron. Yes. So in our chapter, we are going to discuss about this cube, cuboid and pyramid, prism, hemisphere and sphere, cone, cylinder. Okay, we are going to discuss about these figures, as well as sometimes tetrahedron also. Okay, these are the solid figures given in our syllabus. Okay, right, we are going to discuss deeply about these figures. Okay, right. Next, so menstruation deals with the lengths, areas and values. Okay, we know that this menstruation deals with areas and volumes. So what is the difference between the area and volume? So what is area actually? So length is nothing but, look at here, this chalk piece having some length. Okay, so what is the area, what is the volume? Okay, let's see about them. So area is discussed about how much place occupied by the figure. how much place, okay, how much place occupied by the figure. Place is nothing but surface, okay. So suppose if I take a paper, I put it on the board, this board, it occupies some place, isn't it? It occupies some surface. Out of this board, it occupies some surface on the board, okay. That surface which occupied by the paper is called the area. Did you got that? Yes, look at here. Suppose you get here, this is a consider it is a paper, okay. So this is the place occupied by the, this is the place occupied by the paper. So this place is the area occupied by the paper, okay, right. So next, plane figures can have an area. So every plane figure can have a area, okay, right. So units of area we have seen from primary class onwards, we write square centimeter, square meter and square kilometers, okay, nothing but centimeter square, nothing but meter square and kilometer square, okay. So what is the meaning of that? So suppose centimeter square and meter square, and sometimes we see kilometer square also. It means, so what is the formula for area? Length into breadth. This is the formula here I have written. Length and breadth, this is the formula we have. So length is, we measure the length in centimeter or meter or kilometer, okay, isn't it? Right. So that breadth also we measure in centimeter and meter and kilometers, okay. So in both of these, suppose for example, if I want to find area of this rectangle here, so length is 2 centimeters and breadth is 3 centimeters, okay. So what is the area of this rectangle here? 2 centimeter into 3 centimeter, isn't it? Nothing but 2 into 3, it is 6. And centimeter into centimeter? Centimeter square, isn't it? Centimeter into centimeter, it becomes centimeter square. And this we can write 6 square centimeters also. Okay, that is what I have written in this box. Okay. Wait for a while. Right. That is about centimeter square. Okay. And in this way we measure the areas. Okay. And look at here. This is over. And this one is over. And this is also over. Now 3D figures can have curved surface area and total surface area. So suppose, look at here. This is a water bottle. This water bottle having some area, as well as, first of all, look at this. It is a 2D figure or 3D figure? This object is a 3D object, isn't it? This is a 3D object. This water bottle contains some volume. It means, look at here. This is a curved area, isn't it? This is the curved area. And it occupies some place also. If I keep it in my, keep it on my palm, so it occupies some place, isn't it? So this place is nothing but area, okay. And even though it is a 3D object, it occupies some area also. Look at me here, it is having some area, okay. So if I cut this bottle, if I cut this bottle in the vertically, it becomes a thin layer, okay. If I keep this on the board, it occupies some place, okay. So what, that is the meaning of this point. 3D figures can have curved surface. This is a curved shape object, that is why it is having some curved area. Okay, this is nothing but lateral surface area, so we call it. Okay, right. We go for next. Right. So look at here. This is a Rubik's cube, and this is the cylinder. We have seen this. Generally, we see this in our homes. Okay, right. So this is a 3D object, and this is also cylinder is also a 3D object. So look at here. This is a one side. Okay, this is also another side. This is also another side. Like this, it is having more three faces. Okay, right. So one is bottom, and remaining two are sides. Okay, this is a 3D object. So even though it is having some, even though it is having area, so look at here, it is the square shape. This is a square. It is having some area, and this is also having some area, and this part is also having some area. Okay, internally it is occupying some space. What is that? Space. Okay, right. So space is different and place is different. Place means it is area, space means it is volume. Okay, so look at this diagram. Sorry, this is, look at this object. This is a cylinder. We have see this in our home regularly. So this cylinder having some curved area. Okay, this having some curved area, and the gas which contains in this cylinder, okay, it contains some volume of gas. Okay, even though it is a 3D object, it is having curved area as well as it contains some volume of gas. Okay, right. This is about area. I think you have got the idea about area now. Right, next we discuss about volume. So volume discuss about space occupied by the figure or solid. Just now I have said space is different and place is different. Place is nothing but area, and space is nothing but volume. Okay, so what is the meaning of space? Look at here. Just now I have given the example for about this bottle. So this is a bottle. If I keep on my palm, it occupies some place. This is the area. Okay, right. And it is having some height in the space. Okay, it occupies some space in the air. Okay, this is called the volume. Okay, space is nothing but it occupies some height, some breadth, some length. Okay, right. Next, this is over. This is over. Next, solid can have three dimensions. Yes, every solid having length, breadth, and height. Sometimes we see it has depth also. Okay, right. So what is the volume formula? General formula: length into breadth into height is the formula for volume. And next one, a solid can have area and it contains some volume of matter. Is it true? Is it true? Yes, it is true. Look at here. So come back to our bottle again. Yes, this is a three-dimensional object. It nothing but bottle, isn't it? So it is having some curved surface area. Okay, it is having some curved surface area, and it contains some volume of water. Are you able to see the water in the bottle? Yes, it is having some volume of bottle. That is the meaning of contains some volume of matter. Here matter is nothing but water here. Okay, water is also one of the matter. Right, next, this is cylinder. Just now I have given the example for this. So this is the, wait, yes, this is the cylinder. Okay, right. So this is a cylinder. Okay, the cylinder having the some curved surface area as well as it contains some gas in that cylinder, okay, some volume of gas it contains, right? That is the meaning of the previous point. What is that? This point, okay, sorry, that is the meaning of the this point, okay, right? Next we go for another point. That is nothing but over. Next we go for cuboid. So I'm going to introduce here some geometrical figures which is three dimension, okay, right. We go for cuboid first. Yes, this is a cuboid, we have seen lots of time. So this cuboid having the how many faces? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 faces, okay, 6 faces. There is one more figure here, this is also cuboid. And look at here, this cuboid having the depth, okay, as well as height as well as length. Here depth is nothing but breadth, okay, here he has taken depth as breadth. So it is having some height, some length, some depth, okay, right. So in detail here, cuboid, so this is the face, this is the face, and this is also face, and here is also face, 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 okay. How many faces? Total 6 faces. And vertex, these corners are called vertex, okay. How many vertices it is having? It is having 8 vertices, okay, and 12 edges. Edges is nothing but these lines, okay, these lines. It means how many lines it is having? It is having 12 lines, okay, right. This is about cuboid detailly. So now daily life things which we are observing in our daily life, cuboids. So everybody seen this, what is it? Matchbox. This is an example for cuboid, isn't it? And next, duster. We use in our classrooms generally duster, as well as we call it as sponge also. Okay. This is also cuboid, example for cuboid. And next, these are scrubbers. We use to clean our bowls. Okay, this is also example for cuboid. And this is a packing box, this is also example for cuboid, okay, it contains some volume, okay, right. These are also dusters in the different colors we have seen in the market, example for cuboid, cube. So this is a cube, okay, this cube having the all 6 faces, okay, as well as the length, breadth and height. If the length of the cuboid and breadth and height are equal, then that cuboid is called cube. You got my point? If the length of the cuboid is equals to breadth and height, then we can say that is a cuboid. So all the sides, it means so L is equals to B is equals to H in cuboid, okay, right. So this is the close look of the cube. So we here, this indicates all the 3 sides are same length S, and breadth is also S, and height is also S, okay, right. Next, so this is a die we used to play to this, okay. So this is example for cube, okay, and these are also dies, example for cube. This is a packing box, this is also example for cube, okay. Right. Rubik's cube. Just now we have seen the previous examples. So this is a example for cube. Okay. Next we go for cylinder. So a cylinder, look at here, this is a cylinder. Okay, it is having some curved surface and the top. So I will give you next. Okay, the top and the bottom are circular in shape. Okay, circle shape, top and bottom, and the remaining part is curved surface. Okay, the perfect example, this bottle. This bottle is a cylinder. Look at here, this is a cardboard surface and this top is having circular shape and this is also in circular shape. Okay. Right. So look at here, this is also cylinder. This blue color area is the circular shape. So every cylinder having a some radius, okay, with some radius only we can make the cylinder. Okay, and it is having height also. Okay, right, look at here, the thick green parts, this it is, and in the downwards also one thick green part is there, that is also circular in shape, and this curved area is called this curved area is the curved surface. It is having some curved surface. Okay, so every cylinder having some radius. Next, another example. Okay, look at here. So this cylinder having some height and look at radius. And the green parts are having the circular shape and the blue part is the curved surface. Okay, this is the clear picture about cylinder. We see the general examples of cylinder. Yes, this is a cylinder. Okay, isn't it? We have seen in the hospitals and schools as well as some fire stations. Okay, to fill the gas. And this is also cylinder. We have seen daily in our life, and this is a bowl, and we keep our rice, something or whatever may be. This is a example for cylinder, and these pipes we use in the fields to join the pipes. Okay, as well as in our schools also. Okay, this is also cylinder. Next we go for spear. Okay, this is very important, spear. Right. This is a spear. So spear is a it is a rounded in shape. Okay, it is having some radius. Spear having some radius. Look at here, it is having some radius as well as diameter. Diameter is nothing but here height mark. Okay. So the height of the spear is nothing but its height. Remember this thing. So this is also spear. So diameter, nothing but height in spear. Okay. So remember this thing, the external look of the spear is like this. Okay, right, the perfect example we have well known, the balls, cricket balls. Okay, these are the example for spear. This football is also example for spear. This is a volleyball, example for spear. Okay, next we go for hemisphere. Hemisphere is nothing but half of the sphere. Okay, if you make the sphere into equal parts, it makes a hemisphere, two hemispheres. Okay, look at here, this is the hemisphere. So hemisphere also having some radius, okay. So here sometimes the radius becomes height, okay. So look at here in this figure, this is the height of this hemisphere as well as radius also. We show like this the radius, but if we show this vertically, this is the, it becomes height, okay, as well as it is a radius also, okay. We use this concept while solving the problems. Next, this is the hemisphere. Now we see the general examples of sphere which we use in our daily life. These are the we use these things in our daily life, okay. This is a hemisphere. In villages, the people used to store the water in this, okay. This is a perfect example for hemisphere. If you cut the lemon into two equal parts, it becomes two hemispheres, okay. This off part is a hemisphere and this is also hemisphere. So this is also ball, so this ball is also a hemisphere, okay, right. So it look like say man-made thing it is, okay. It means artificial thing it is. So this is also example for sphere. And look at, observe carefully here. Here it contains two hemispheres, okay. So this internal part is a one hemisphere, this external part is also another hemisphere, okay. So it means, suppose if I draw like this, it is, okay, I will make it clear. So for example, this is the internal sphere and this one is the external sphere. So it is having some radius and it is also having some radius, okay. This called as capital R and this is the smaller, okay. This concept we use in our problems, okay, right. Next, cone. So just here I am introducing the shapes, okay. What is what? So this is a cone. Every cone having some radius and height, okay. This is the, this point is a vertex, okay. This is the height and this is a slant height and this is the radius. Every cone having some radius and the bottom of the cone is a circle, okay. The bottom of the cone is a circle, the base is a circle per cone. Next, so close image of the cone. So it is having some radius and this is a slant height and vertex height. So slant height is the important thing here, remember that thing. So altitude is nothing but here height, okay. Altitude is nothing but here height. So altitude nothing but height, okay. Remember, wherever you look altitude, it is nothing but height of the given figure, okay. This is the general examples of cone, okay. So this is a birthday cap. Generally we use this thing, okay. This is a perfect example for cone. So this we observe in our roads as well as traffic signals. So this is ice cream cone it is. These are the cones and this is a playing thing. Kids use it to play with this. And this is a, if I generally we observe in the grounds, okay, and building constructions, we see like this figure. And when we are playing in the ground, generally we observe this kind of earth, okay. So this is a cone, okay. but it is having some depth. It is not having the height, it is having the depth. The depth we consider as height, okay? Next, these are the examples for cone. Next, come to pyramid. So, pyramid is famous in Egypt. Right, this is the pyramid. So, the base of the pyramid is a, look like a square, okay? So, this is the base. So, here it is having, this is the base and this is the height of the pyramid. Height, okay, altitude is nothing but height only. This altitude is nothing but height only, okay? And next, this is also pyramid. Observe closely here. And so if we fill the color in pyramid, it becomes like this. So just we need to understand the pyramid concept, okay? Right. So this is the real pyramid, it is. Okay, example for pyramid, and this is a pyramid. Generally, Hindus were pray on the some. I think in my home also, like this pyramid is there. So generally, we do the meditation under this pyramid. Okay. So these are the playing things. Yes, this is, look at here, this thing we used in our, what is that? Yes, this thing we use for paperweight in our offices as well as schools, okay? That is the example for pyramid. Next, prism. So this is a triangular prism, or we can call it as right prism also. In the previous cone, that is a right cone, okay? A right cone, as well as pyramid is also a right pyramid or triangular pyramid, okay? This is a prism. This we can call it as triangular prism also. Okay, this is the base, and look at here. This triangular pyramid having the two bases. One is this. And there is this side, okay? And sometimes we take this is also, this face is also, if we put it like this, it is also becomes base, okay? So it is having multiple bases, so we take that as a faces, okay? Right. Right, these are the different types of prisms. Right, general example for prism. So this Dera, the army men's, generally army men use it to stay in this, okay? We have seen movies also. So net, this is also in shape of prism, okay? Right. So this is about our introduction of menstruation topic. So what we learned here, just I'm quickly recap the concepts. What we learned here, so here we have learned geometrical figures in 2D and 3D. In the next video we are going to solve some problems, as well as we shall know about the formulas. Thank you.